This is Sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
I'll shake your body.
Wake your fuck ass up.
I got a call from a good friend of mine about an artist I've been peeping out lately.
Okay.
I catch him doing some of the festivals when I go online. Post Malone.
Love Post Malone.
Friend of the show.
Post, yeah. Absolutely.
You got a chance to sit and talk with him. And Heather B was hosting
Soundset
last
year. Yeah, Soundset last year in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And he was great. Just tore up the stage. It was great. But I became a huger fan since his performance.
Well, you know, I like when artists like a Post Malone or a G-Eazy or a Drake in his early days kind of, you know, give the nod to other artists and open doors to help add to the momentum they've already been building. And I was watching the Hollywood Dreams tour, I think it was called, Hollywood Dreams tour, and there was an artist on there from T-Dot to Six. Mm. I don't know if I'm saying it right. They change the name every month. Every album is a different nickname for it. T-Dot, the Six, it's this kid on there named Jazz Cartier. And I was like, I took note to him because I liked his style. One of the stage shows, I saw him come out on stage on a bicycle or something. I think
nice.
It was.
Whoa.
And I was like, well, I mean, he on that bike, but can he do bike tricks? You know, and so I was like, one day I'm going to ask him on the show and see if he can give me an answer to that question. Welcome him to the show, Jazz Cartier, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, Jazz. Hey. Welcome.
Thank you.
So let me ask you a question, man. Because I used to, you know, collect bikes. I used to have a Black Mamba frame, this old school, a Red Line frame.
Yeah.
Started with the Huffy frames, you know. We used to have the different types of rims we used to buy for the bikes. Are you in the bike culture, or that was just a stage?
I'm not a bike guy myself, to be honest with you.
You're not a bike guy?
Nah, I was getting on stage, and I saw the bike, and I was just like, why not?
Oh. Being in the moment.
Yeah, so I pulled up on stage on the bike, you know? And, yeah.
That's what happened.
I don't know whose bike it was, but.
You don't even know what bike it was.
I don't.
Man, the way you rode it out there, you just threw it down like it was nothing. I thought you was a trickster on the bike.
Nah, man, I'm taking. I don't like, you know, stuff too physical to get hurt. You know, I'm taking it easy. You know what I'm saying? I'm fragile.
You're a fragile guy,
I'm
man.
Fragile.
What other random things have you had on stage?
Fire extinguisher.
Fire extinguisher.
That wasn't a smart idea.
Yeah. Okay.
How'd that turn out?
I mean, no one got hurt. Thank God. Yeah. But yeah. I'll never do that one again.
Mm-hmm.
Crowd walking, climbing stuff.
Yeah.
Whatever I can find, really, is like spur of the moment. It's like once I'm on the stage, I just see red and, you know, things happen.
Things happen.
Yeah.
It's interesting because Jazz Cartier's demeanor on stage is a lot different from who he is off stage, which is, I enjoy the contrast.
Mm-hmm.
Do we find that in your approach to music as well?
Yeah. I feel like everyone says that about me.
Yeah?
Yeah. That, like, through the music, they probably think that I'm some, like, crazy kid, always on 100 every time you see me, but I'm chilling.
Yeah. You got a Sasha Fierce.
Yeah. Yeah. You know?
Okay, great. Okay. Okay. Yeah.
What's the boys' version of Sasha Fierce? Jazz Cartier? That's
yeah. There it is, yeah. Right there.
It is,
I got
right there.
It.
You just
got
know
it.
That.
What are you doing in your downtime? And you said you like to chill. So what's the chilling? Is it reading? Is it, you know, just listening to other artists' albums? Some artists don't like to do that, you know? What's your chill time like?
I watch a lot of movies. I watch a lot of tennis. I try to listen to as much podcasts as possible. I watch a lot of interviews online with other artists, et cetera, et cetera. It just depends.
Why tennis?
I mean, growing up, everybody in my family played soccer, you know, and my mom wanted me to do something else, and she's always, like, forward-thinking, you know. She's like, one day you're going to thank me for putting you in tennis, because not a lot of Black boys your age are playing tennis, you know. So she got me in it at an early age. I didn't like it at first, but as I got older and like realized that like no one around me was doing it, it kind of made me feel, you know, special that I was good at something that, like, you know, I can put on for, you know, our people in such a predominantly white sport.
Hell yeah. So you watch it in your downtime, do you still play?
I haven't played it. Last time I played was like about a year and a half ago. Yeah. Oh,
that's, time. Not, that's not bad.
Yeah, but yeah. You did watch the game against Nadal and Federer recently. Yeah, wasn't that classic?
It was good.
That was a good game, man. Good. Right. So you did you grow up in Toronto or did you travel a lot as a kid?
I was born in Toronto. I left when I was about 7 or 8, and then since then I moved all over. You know, Kuwait, Barbados. I was in Houston, Connecticut, Maine, Virginia. Spent some time in, I'm forgetting some places.
Jersey.
Nah.
I just gotta get Jersey. Right.
That's kind of where you end up, Heather. Yeah. That's not where you go. You don't go there. You end up there.
Not Jersey, but yeah.
I was born there.
All in all, I went to like 13 schools, you know. Mm-hmm. And then once I graduated high school, I had the option of going to Chicago for college, but I didn't want to start over again. The whole phase, I was conditioned to it. I was used to it. I didn't want to be the new kid again. So I just moved back home. And then that's when things started happening.
That's when the music started firing up. Mm-hmm. I would imagine that you got a lot of influences from all this travel, you know, because mm-hmm. your music isn't marginalized. What do you think? What gave you the audacity to think that you could become a performer? Was it what did your pops introduce? Your stepfather? Like who introduced that idea to you?
My mom really put like the music. She like always had music playing in the house. Mm-hmm. You know, she was straight up R&B. You know, but then she also had. Do you mind if I get a water by any chance?
Yeah, get this man some water, man. Water. Yeah, man. We just trying to, you know.
All these lights on me.
I hear you, bro.
Hot.
It gets cold.
Let's come back.
You feel me?
Yes, let's come back.
I was in the bathroom earlier. I almost had like an 8 Mile moment, you know, and like almost threw up.
You almost threw up.
It happens. You wouldn't be the first.
Nervous. You wouldn't be the first. That's why we're trying to ease you in, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know, get tennis. To know Jazz Cartier. We got Dead or Alive. Let's play Dead or Alive. Jazz Cartier. This is off of which project?
Marauder in Paradise.
Yeah, that's a classic for him already. Mm-hmm. All right, here it is. 888-742-3345. They want me dead or alive. Yeah. They want me dead or alive.
Yep.
Trying to survive. Who wants you? Mm.
People, man.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's a cruel world out there.
It's a cruel world. It's dirty out there.
It's all facts.
We got a rule over here. Tell them rule number one.
It's a dirty game.
It is.
Jazz Cartier is here. You've had some real long-term success. You had milestone moments.
Yeah.
You know, your first project came out, I feel like, around 2011, 2012. Mm-hmm. Right? Am I accurate with this?
Yeah, that was a little basement project that me and Lance did.
And Lance is your producer.
Yeah, Lance is, you know, the right-hand man. He's the one that's produced on all the projects. And then me and him took, like, 3 years to just... focus on ourselves and just like focus on like the music. We would like make so many songs and not put anything out because we just weren't comfortable with like what we had, but we knew we were onto something, you know. Uh-huh. And it took like 3-4 years, but eventually we got around to it. And then, you know, stuff like Dead or Alive came out.
Uh-huh.
New Religion, and then that's the first project, that's like our first official project, Marauder in Paradise, that came out 2015.
Okay.
And we had like 5 versions of it before like the final one came out. The final one came out, had the city going crazy, you know.
Uh-huh.
Pitchfork gave it a review. It was like the first Toronto mixtape to get like a Pitchfork review since like So Far Gone's debut, you know. Mm-hmm. So like that was like big for us.
Yeah.
You know?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
You know, some like kids just me and him on the mixtape. No features, no other co-productions, me and Lance. So, you know, little incremental gains.
Uh-huh.
It's where I like to keep that mindset, you know. As long as you keep progressing, you know, shit should be Gucci.
Yeah, it's artist development.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, which is we don't see a lot of that in this digital age because it's so easy to just throw anything out, and they waited 5 versions of the same project before you felt it was ready.
But like Lance and I, Lance doesn't really have like a traditional hip hop background.
Yeah.
You know, and I have a very traditional, like I came up on like Black Sheep, Tribe, you know, Jungle Brothers. Like that's what my mom put me on. you know.
Native tongue, huh?
You know.
Shout out to moms.
Yeah. Black sheep, you can get with this.
You can get with that.
Okay, know? That makes sense to me.
You know, and yeah, so like, even back in the day when I first started rapping, like I modeled like a lot of my rap style off like Dress, you know,
uh-huh.
and like Mr. Long and Eric B, Rakim, like. I'm only 23, you know, and like when I say this, it kind of gets people like, they don't really understand it, but like that's, I was in Barbados and I really had nothing to do but like play tennis, go to school. So on my downtime, my mom had a CD collection with like classics, you know, from Outkast to E-40s, you know what I'm saying? So like everything, Too Short, and then, you know, all of New York, because she was from Toronto, but she had everything else uh-huh. that she just stacked up on, and I just literally took in everything from that to like Janet to Whitney's, you know, like everything. So I got pretty cultured at a very young age, you know. So shout out to my mom.
Yeah, I need to be interviewing your mom.
Word, wide range of black excellence.
Don't come alone next time. Jazz Cartier is here.
It's hard to have a conversation about Toronto and not bring up Drake.
Facts.
And I'm curious to know, when you think of him, does competition come more to mind or camaraderie?
Camaraderie.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to think about it. Like, some kids are going to be, you know, super aggressive, being like, I'm all about me, you know, fuck that.
Uh-huh.
I don't give a fuck about anybody else, yada, yada. But, like, in the grand scheme of things, it's like, yeah, we've had successes in the past, but not on, like, a global scale. Uh-huh. Not to a point where, like, you go to Europe or you're going to fucking Scandinavia or someplace like that, and people are screaming out, you know, streets in Toronto, like I'm running through the six, you know what I'm saying? Like people actually, like, they come to Toronto just based off what they hear in this music, and like that's what people have felt when like they bump Nas back in the day, you know, when they bump Jay, when they bump Pac, like they would always talk about their surroundings, and then they would go to these places and then they would feel the music. But Toronto never really had that on a global scale. So for like someone like Drake to be doing that for me is like crazy. Like even when he first came out, I was in Connecticut, and you know, naturally all the black kids, you know, we formed together at like all white schools. But and like most of my friends were from New York. So when we had like rap conversations, this is when Drake first came out, and I was being very bold because I didn't really have anybody from the city that I can like, you know, put a stamp on. But they would say, obviously, Jay-Z's the God. But, you know, I'd be like, nah, Drake's the God. You
Drake's
know?
The God. You were saying it back then?
Had to, bro.
You gotta rep your, hey man, you gotta rep your set, kid. I ain't mad at that.
Shit, his predictions was on point.
I ain't mad at that. And I love when those two go back and forth with them little bit and little subliminal lines. One day it might come.
It's good for the culture, you know.
It's great for the culture, man. Those are two amazing artists who are doing great things on and off the court.
Yeah.
But so are you. I mean, you've had a lot of success with your music. I know Raptors games, you know, those, you know, you could hear him being played at the Raptors games.
That's
had to
flames.
Be.
Shout out to Four Corners for that, you know.
How did that happen?
I mean, just the reception of the city, you know. Like, that little gap that I had when I wasn't putting out music, I was really in the streets, you know. Like, you couldn't go anywhere without seeing me. And it got to a point where everyone was like, all right, I keep seeing this kid's face, but, like, what does he really do? You know, but I was waiting for that moment where like I kind of exhausted my public appearance to a point where I needed to drift back. And then the moment I fell back, that's when I was going to attack with the music, because then once the music came out, no one was going to see me because everyone was going to expect to see me, you know, because it's like a usual thing, I guess, everywhere else, but mostly in my city, where it's like, someone would like drop a song, go out that same weekend and expect, you know, everyone to play it, you know, Snapchat, blah, 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 blah. I was like, let me put this out and just fall back, and no one's going to see me for a grip, you know.
That was Switch?
Switch.
Yeah.
Switch was the first one that he started playing at the Raptors games, and, you know, since then, every other song I drop, he fucks with it. So shout out to Four Corners.
Man, I'm about to get floor seats. Heather B.
Take me.
I'm about to get floor seats. I know Jazz Cartier got me. This is one of the songs you would hear being played at the Raptors game. 888-742-3345. Give us a call. Yeah. I'm a big Ballers fan.
Great show.
Great show. Mm-hmm. Denzel's son on there. The Rock. Mm-hmm. You know, great show. And you.
Me.
Your music got licensed. 100 yeah. Roses, right?
100 Roses.
Yep. And that was, when that happened, where were you at in your career?
I was actually in Europe, mm-hmm. and I couldn't watch it. So I was getting tweets about it. I knew it was coming out, but I would get tweets about it. And I was in Europe for like 3 weeks after that, so I kind of lost track of the show. But then I came back from Europe. Then I went on like another festival run. Then I went on the Post Malone tour. And then once I finally watched the full episode, I think like in December.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it came out in August, but it was pretty cool. You know,
they hear your song going. Yeah. He playing crazy. It, downplaying it.
Oh, like yeah, that. He humble.
He's pretty cool, man. Yeah. My song was on TV. You know, that's amazing. Hey, look, they heard it before.
Told my mama if I died and put them roses on my casket. If I burn that Aoki smoking on my ashes, my city's in the race on whoever make it the fastest. I'm fucking past it, knocking niggas like I'm Cassius. I ain't around. Mm. I ain't around. I heard they talking down, they talking down. You know Jacuzzi got the heat, I'm always up to something. But they only talking down cause they ain't up and coming.
Grill up, grill up! Jazz Cartier. I'm just playing hit after hit, so you catch this vibe right now.
There's a catalog.
It's a catalog. Go to his I was just swimming through his SoundCloud. It's like, oh damn, oh damn. He got some bangers. Man, you got my young homie right here, Prince of Zamunda. That's his DJ name. Right here, you got a couple 15-year-olds. Yeah, yeah. You got a question for him, man?
Yes, I actually have two.
What's up?
First question is, do you need a tour DJ?
Do I need a tour DJ?
Get to the point,
shout out to Zamunda, man. I mean... I got one right now, but maybe in the future, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If like shit works out, you know what I'm saying? Keep doing your thing for sure.
And if you had one person to work with, who do you think that person would be?
If I had one person to work with, it kind of changes every day. One person.
You thinking Celine Dion?
Right.
Actually, if it's one person, I'd say Lil Wayne.
Okay.
Wayne.
Yeah.
That's a great choice.
I'd say Wayne.
Didn't you do a song? Did you ever?
I did.
You did a song called Lil Wayne.
I did. Yeah.
That's right. Yeah. You know, I remember you had the clip of Wayne saying, somebody asking him when did he first start rapping or something in front of that.
Mm-hmm.
So you really, what is it about Wayne?
I mean, I grew up watching BET and like VH1 and stuff, and seeing like the big timers and like the hot boys on that just like, I don't know, when you're young you don't really notice it, but like growing up it just like it like there's like a seed in your head that starts growing, you know.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know, he's just been one of my favorites for years. But yeah, I did that track Lil Wayne, and 2 days later Wayne tweeted about it, you know. And I mean, I think that made me like him even more.
Yeah. That tuned in, right?
Yeah, exactly.
You ever communicate with him?
I haven't. We were supposed to do like 2 shows together, like festivals, but he couldn't make them last minute. But I'm billed on the same festival as him May 5th at Rolling Loud in Miami. So hopefully that happens, you know.
Chance to meet him, right?
Yeah.
Lil Wayne, yeah. Jazz Cartier is here. Your new album is called Forever.
Forever.
And I'm a botanist. I don't know if you know this. I keep a lot of plants in my house.
That's what's up.
I don't keep a lot of plants in my house.
It's a new thing with this guy. Something else gets added to his resume. I thought he was going to say he played tennis too.
Ain't no pictures of you with tennis, B.
Nah.
I could call my best friend from high school, Eric Matthews, right now.
Mm-hmm.
When we went to Mary Junior College on the top of the hill in Oakland, California.
That's what you got to do it every day.
I got to do it every day. I got to prove myself, man. We used to play tennis. We took tennis courses in the whole nine. you know, I had a little cut on my serve.
You getting your Arthur Ashe on.
I got my Arthur Ashe on. I was motivated by Arthur. But anyway, I didn't decide to pursue that, obviously.
It's not for everybody, you feel me?
It's not for everybody. What is your, you have a obsession or a affinity for flowers?
Yeah, man. I just feel like with flowers is like the, it's something that you can celebrate life with and celebrate death with and everything in between, you know. It's pretty much life, you know, a flower.
True.
So, yeah, that's what I base my whole brand off of, you know. I tell people to water their flowers, nurture relationships, you know, make sure things keep growing and don't let anything really die, you know, because all that shit comes back around, you know.
You grow?
Weed?
I didn't see that. Come on, man. I wasn't gonna put that stigma on you, but I guess that's the first thing that came to mind. I guess
I don't grow weed.
Nah, but you grow plants.
I don't grow plants.
You don't?
No.
Okay.
Eventually, I think I'm gonna get into it, but I mean, I live in Toronto. No plants are growing anytime soon.
Nah, man, it's cold up there.
Cold as hell,
dude. When you jump into that area, holler at me. I got, you know, different plants. You know some people. Things. I know me.
He does that.
Come on, Cool Z. I know me. I know me, kid.
That's what's up.
Talk about the koozie on that. What koozie? What's that? I see these hoodies.
Yeah. Well, jacuzzi is my little, you know, AKA.
Okay.
Jacuzzi LaFleur, and you know, I made this little hoodie. You know, it's like a Gucci flip.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's just what it is.
XL, dog.
I got you. I got everybody, actually.
You got us all?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Everybody.
Forever. So conceptually, is it? You seem like you evolve, and if you look at from the Losing Elizabeth to the Marauding in Paradise, Hotel Paranoia, you evolve each time. How did you evolve on this one?
Well, I'm currently in the process of evolving, you know, because, you know, we're still making it, but with Forever, it's pretty much, like, conceptually, it's pretty much about the flower that never dies, you know, so... That's where I'm at with that.
Okay.
Trying to make music that's forever. That stands the test of time. So
that's interesting, because a lot of people are just throwing away music, making throwaway music. I want that moment. Mm-hmm. I want that summer. I don't care about that winter or that spring.
Yeah. I mean, like, summer only lasts like, what, 2 months?
Yeah.
What? Right. That's global crazy. Warming.
I like that.
1 month.
I see a little Mr. Long look in him, too. Like the style you got. I peep it. I see him a lot of little flavors. Look like me as a young man. Wow. Come on. Nah, Heather, that's come true. On. I that's wasn't true. Rock. I got pictures. So y'all need to pull out the pictures.
You know what's crazy? Yeah. It's like you look exactly like my Uncle Andrew, which is mind boggling to me.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, we could be related.
We might be.
Who knows?
Your uncle's a handsome guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
40 and Sway, your cousins. You know.
That, thank you, man. Yeah. 40's my cousin.
That's what's up.
Well, you know how this show works, right?
Yeah. Man. He said he watches interviews.
He watches. You watch ours?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes, okay.
Obviously, I do.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Anything we could do to improve on our style? We really don't have a style. We just hollering.
You know,
I'll take like constructive criticism though.
Make sure you guys have waters on deck.
Okay.
Super important.
That's important.
You know what I'm saying? A masseuse would be good.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? It gets kind of tense in here.
It does, doesn't it?
You know?
Yeah.
Y'all need some more plants in here too.
Okay.
Plants.
You know?
Okay, cool.
It's a little, you know what I'm saying? Spice up the little feng shui a little bit.
I agree with that one.
A picture of me right there.
Right next to Eminem or just right here?
No, just right here.
There. Okay.
Yeah. Just call it Jazz 4-5 from
Jazz
now on.
Jazz 4-5. Okay. Got I like it. That. I like that.
You know? That's sorry, Em. I'm trying to make a little executive decision out here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But yeah.
Okay,
I think,
cool. All right. Thank
yeah.
you. we got our new intern write down those notes for us, okay?
Yeah.
And then any kind of beat you think we should play, like that kind of, you know, that you like, perhaps?
Maybe just to set the mood.
Don't play that weak shit, though. Just play anything but the weak shit, you feel
okay,
me?
Okay, yeah. Let's see what we got here. And if I play this, you think you can spit something on this?
Oh, my God.
You think you got something for me?
Yeah, I think so.
Jazz Cartier.
Turn me up.
Sway in the morning. Shade 4-5.
So loud at the beat, goddamn!
Yeah.
Sorry.
Look.
Come on.
It's the death letter.
in the middle of the crowd and I'm dead center. In the year I've done shit that you can't measure. I don't feel pressure, I don't get bitter, I just get better. You be following trends and I'm a trendsetter. I've been mastering chess cause I don't play checkers. Getting money is the only way I feel pleasure in this cool weather. I'm getting corporate checks and getting checks from Nike. There's no one like me, it's so unlikely. If you hate and bite me, and no man can match my psyche. Got so-called friends trying to sway. Look, niggas in my city try to rap just like me and act just like me, but that's when that shit get feisty. 416 till I exit. I'm the reason why y'all ain't shit. I'm the reason why y'all exist. Steph Curry on the line, nigga, I don't miss. I got Henny in my veins, nigga, I stay lit. Shit, look, look, look. I turn pennies into nickels, nickels into dimes, dimes into quarters, grapes into wine. Say the word and I do it every time. Say the word and I do it every time. Look, and I used to lose hope and shit, but them drugs help me cope with shit. And I ain't no fashion nigga, but you see me in the dope and shit. I'm even back on my smoking shit. It's the game of life, but like games can't play it twice. Close my eyes and roll the dice. Everything worth having has a crazy price. And nowadays I live a crazy life, but now you got cops killing niggas. That's why I'm not watching you niggas, and I hope shit pop for you niggas. I be on the clock with it, nigga. If you hatin' on Koozie, stop with it, nigga, man. And everybody's out to get me. Went from moving coke to a deal with Pepsi, Frank, Abagnale. They can't catch me. Check my stats. I'm lucky lefty, just like Gretzky, Koozie.
Oh my God, it's hot.
Oh.
Oh wow. We can go again.
We could go again. We got a new factor in the gang, Toronto.
We can go again, man.
We got a new factor again.
Jazz.
Sway in the Morning, home of the real MC, home of the hyenas.
Hi,
DJ Wonder.
Howdy.
You can only hear the skill on beats like this.
Yup.
All right. I think I got some of this.
You got something for that?
Yeah. Prince of the motherfucking city, man, Jazz Cartier. Look, I don't follow suit. My back hands like Serena when I follow through. I'd end up in a ditch if I followed you. My focus is getting rich and taking care of the clique. Oh shit, flowers in the bed, you know where I've been. I can name a lot of friends that ain't came and went. And my emotions like money well spent. I'm the cold-hearted nigga, I don't ever feel shit. Look, small dick niggas playing peekaboo. Tell them it's a flirt when you ask them who you speaking to. About to go to Switzerland, kick it for a week or two. Hot temper, product of Toronto, so I guess I gotta keep it cool. Leave me on the island and I'll show you where they get it at. Feeling like the man, first time you bought that fitted cat. Money on my mind, every band is like a thinking cat. Boy, you just got that Rolex? I was trying to get rid of that. I got 50-11 bitches, and all of them pretty. Time to go away, all of them miss me. Mom was an angel, so I had to give a hell. I'm a Mac, big girls, all looking like Adele. Got money in the pantry, bills on every shelf. People like the way it feels, but I like the way it smells. Cartier, Skip Prague, bitch, covered in Chanel. Wonder why she stick around when she in love with someone else. That's the shit I wonder when I'm fucking someone else. You can't afford to do this shit to your health. Don't get your company murdered, shit will come with a burden. You tryna ride on the wave, I'm tryna fuck up the current. I'm tryna get me a driver, whip come with the curtains. Matter of fact, who let you clowns run away from the circus? How you up in the club and you still flipping them burgers? Man, shit. Next one.
Wake up show right now.
Has
a big, he said, next one.
Give me some of hype, man. Give me some of hype, man.
Yeah, okay. Damn, we should have did the five fingers. Shit.
Give me some of hype, man.
Give me some. Hey, yo, throw something at him. Don't worry about the cube. Let the cube fall.
Yeah.
Don't worry about the cube.
Yeah.
Did you like Lil Wayne?
Nah, something out.
Because he spit two fire verses. I want to. Let's work with it. Come
right.
on.
All right.
You got any suggestions? Sure, you know.
Ready? How about
no? Yeah, let's go. Hold up. Jazz Cartier, Forever. That's Forever. The name of the project
coming out.
Tempted. That's the name of the single.
Big one. Big tune.
We gonna do that in a second. But I'm really enjoying this. Fresh off the plane from the Super Bowl. Whenever I travel, I come back so lucid it's hard to adjust to the bull crap in the game.
Yeah.
So when I get realness here, it gets me excited right now. When I get a real hyena up in here, it gets me thoroughly excited.
I like it.
By the way, there we go.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm.
All right. Look.
What up, Wayne?
Shout out to Wayne.
Manny Fresh.
Look, Koozie, baby. I got it. Alright, look. JLF, yeah. JLF, yeah. Look. Mama said, never take advice from a nigga with no money. This is my world, don't tell me how to run it. Old niggas, they washed up. Joe Budden got enough to feed the needy. Tell that nigga, hold some, yeah. New nigga, cool sicker. Pull up in the roof missing with two bitches. They know a nigga do business at Roof Chris's. Got maids that'll fry chicken, do dishes. Now they know the wave is hot, the face is hot. Watching all the rings I cop and chains I rock. Cartier frames and watch, I made a lot. From days had to make the wop, then make the drop. But nigga, no, all my old shit was just practice. But now the heat is on, now we need some action. And everybody want what they not having. Sway, even Katy Perry needed herself some black dick. Fuck boys love talking down on the internet. Watching other niggas still haven't touched a million yet. Koozie, wait, I didn't mean what I said. But that shit that you say will get you knocked on your head. I'm the god body, this shit is no hobby. 12 come around, we ain't talking to nobody. Bitch pulling up in the Ritz, Bugatti. My new chain, Lil Wayne Gretzky. No hockey, went from sleeping on the floor to a magazine cover. Now I don't wear jeans to the Japanese touch it. I'm late to the show in the limousine, fucking with the crystalline tint, so they couldn't see nothing. Man, at 21 I had to let go of the trap. At 22 I let niggas know it's a rap. Now 23 I got the whole city on my back. And I ain't scared of you motherfuckers. Put that on Bernie Mac, JLF.
We good? Jazz Cartier. A real hyena, ladies and gentlemen.
That's
nerve-wracking. Oh, nah, man. I got to fact check real quick, though.
That was nerve-wracking.
Let me fact check real quick.
Shake it.
You said you like big girls like Adele.
Facts.
You like the big girls?
Facts.
Okay. Big girls need loving too.
They do.
Mm-hmm.
You said your mother was an angel, so you had to give her hell.
Mm-hmm.
You selling cocaine?
Or? Yeah.
Things happen.
You said 21, you had to let go of the trap.
Yeah.
Well, what's crap? What city?
We was in Toronto getting it, you feel me?
Yeah?
Yeah.
I would imagine it's hard to get it in the trap in Toronto.
I mean, you can imagine a lot of things can happen.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, the world is the world, you know?
The world is the world. I really like your style, brother. I really enjoyed that.
Thank you, Sway.
No, I'm dead ass. Like, I enjoyed that. I like when a person says, give me another beat. That, man, I know you a real ass MC for saying that.
Thank
when you,
man.
Said, and you did it a second time too.
You finished factoring?
Okay. Oh no. But those are three standout. You got something you want
to
hit him?
Yeah. What Joe Budden do to you?
Oh yeah, that's that.
And Katy Perry, she was on your meat. What happened?
Nothing. No offense to Joe. Shout out to Joe. You know. Shout out to Katy too.
You said use them old
niggas,
bro.
And then Joe Budden. You use them as a simile.
Right.
I mean, yeah.
Well, you know, Joe and Drake had that moment. Was you was defending?
Oh, right.
No. I'm not defending no man's battles or nothing. You know what I'm saying? Just you know what I'm saying. Shit happens.
It rhyme.
If nigga does anything that's washed, you know.
Yeah.
Got to call him out for it.
Yeah. Call him Joe Budden.
Shout out to Joey though.
Heather, you know Heather's from Jersey, so that's a.
I like Pump It Up.
You know what?
Yo, this.
Okay, let's go over to Katy Perry now. What she said, she needs some. I'm not gonna touch that. She needs some black meat. What happened to Katy Perry?
Katy does. She walking funny, you know?
Katy. You know?
She needs some soul in her music. You know what I'm saying? So.
It's a beautiful young lady, man.
I'm just looking out for the culture.
Yeah.
I like this kid right here, Jazz Cartier.
He's cracking up, too. Okay.
Hey, man, you just got to come up and hang out with us one day. Hey, we got the interview out.
I'm down. You know.
Hang out with us.
I'm down.
True MC. I like what's going on. All MCs from Toronto that have come here, including Torey Lanez.
Shout out to my boy Torey.
Yep. Have come prepared.
Yes.
So the bar has risen in T-Dot.
It has to.
because you got a big inspiration that's walking around the town at any given moment.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And I commend you, man. I can't wait for the album to get done. When it does, please Same come here. Back.
For sure.
All right.
For sure. Thank you guys for having me.
Jazz Cartier, y'all want to talk him directly. Hit him up. Let him know what you thought of those verses. Hit him up on his social media. Get that out for me.
Jazz Cartier on Twitter. Jacuzzi LaFleur on Instagram. Jazz Cartier on SoundCloud. Snapchat, all that stuff. You know.
You enjoy yourself here today, man?
I had fun. I'm actually really, really nervous. Yeah. You guys can't see. Except I'm wearing the glasses on some like real rapper shit. You
yeah.
know?
That works.
Yeah. And I'm like sweating crazily. So when I go outside, I'm taking everything off and, you know, do a leap of faith. But, you know, thank you guys again.
Nah, you did your thing, brother. Thank Jazz you. Cartier, man. You true MC, man.
Pleasure, man.
True MC.
For sure.
True MC, that's a whole nother level. Heather, let it go. It's just a
Jersey
it was a
run. Stand up. I got five for Jersey, Joe Rodriguez, Red Man, Track,
okay,
World
okay,
Jersey.
Okay, shout out to Jersey.
The one.
All right. All right, hey, man, we got shout, go ahead.
Shout out Tretch, too. You know?
Tretch, yeah,
you
gotta, no doubt. Ooh, ooh, yeah. My ooh, nature.
Ooh, you know? Tretch.
Yeah.
Okay. Outsiders?
Outside, everybody, yeah, okay. Rodriguez, hey, Jersey.
Okay. Up next. Fat Joe is here. Got a couple Grammy nominations. He's gonna talk to us. We're gonna go commemorate the life of Big Pun and his new project with Remy Ma. That's next. You wanna talk with Fat Joe? 888-742-3345.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shade 45.